We are now going to find, download, and add shapefiles of country borders and other geographical data to our map. On your web browser, go to the Natural Earth Data website. The link is in the video description. Click on the Downloads tab. There are now different options. We can download data at large, medium, and small scale. We can also choose to download cultural vector data, such as country borders and cities, physical vector data, such as land, sea, rivers, or raster versions of this data. We are going to start with the cultural data, and we want the most detailed version, so we're going to click Cultural under Large Scale Data. There are many different data sets we could choose, but we want the countries data. So under Admin Zero Countries, click Download Countries. Save this in your GIS folder, or cut and paste it from your downloads into your GIS folder. We now want to add this country's data into our map in QGIS. So, on the toolbar, click Open Data Source Manager, click the Vector tab, and select the Browse button. The country's zip file should be in your GIS folder, but we want to put it in a Natural Earth folder to keep all of this data together. So click New Folder and type Natural Earth. Drag the zip file into the Natural Earth folder and then double click. Right click the zip file and go to 7-zip, extract here. If you don't have 7-zip, you can install it. There's a link in the video description. Change all files to Esri shapefiles, click the country's shapefile, and click Open, Add, and then Close. We now have polygons of all the countries of the world over the top of our base map. If you can't see it, then drag it in the Layers panel to the top above the other layers. We want to be able to see the Google Earth imagery or other imagery through this country data. So in order to do this, right click the country shape file in the layers panel and select Properties. Click on the Symbology tab and click Simple Fill. Change Simple Fill to Outline Simple Line and click OK. We can now see the Google Earth imagery through the country's data. If we want to change the color of the line or make it a bit thicker, we go back to Properties, click on Simple Line, and then we can change this thickness to perhaps 0.5, and we can change the color by clicking the arrow next to color and selecting the color that we want and clicking OK. Don't forget to save your work by clicking the Save button on the toolbar. Try downloading the populated places and rivers shapefiles from the Natural Earth website and making your map look like this.